عسلامة عسلامة، ومرحبا بكم في قناتي، قناة تعلم اللغة الإنجليزية مع الأستاذة نجلة. هذا الأسبوع بدأت الامتحانات النهائية للثلاثي الأول، أتمنى التوفيق للجميع، لذلك اخترت لكم هذا الفيديو وهو كمراجعة للغة الامتحان اللغة الإنجليزية قبل الامتحان. إذن هو عبارة على Reading Comprehension، نص نقوم بالإجابة على الأسئلة، ثم بعد ذلك لدينا تمارين في اللغة language practice. So before starting, just I would like to advise you one advice. In each reading comprehension test, you have to read the text twice or three times in order to understand the text and answer reading comprehension questions correctly. قبل كل امتحان reading comprehension عليكم قراءة النص مرتين أو ثلاث مرات حتى تتمكنوا من فهم النص جيداً، وبالتالي إجاباتكم على الأسئلة تكون إجابات صحيحة. So let's start. I'm going to read the text in English, then explain it to you in Arabic language. So read the text and answer the questions. The long summer holidays are finally over and some parents are pleased. But why? We worry very much about their safety in the holidays, explains one mother from North London. If teenagers are not wandering around on public transport in a big and dangerous city, they are chatting to strangers in an internet chat room. Weekends are not the only time to worry. Newspapers are full of stories about too many school kids going to school by car because their parents do not want them to travel alone on a bus or train. This summer, there were more frightening stories of teenagers disappearing with unsuitable friends that they met on the net. All the media stories help increase parents' fears. Many young people feel that life for their parents was easier. In 1960s, young people played in the streets more and traveled around the town without their parents. Now, many young people have mobile phones and their parents ring to find out where they are. I use my mobile to get dad to come to the station when I arrive late. 16-year-old Jane said, mobiles are not just expensive toys. They help keep young people safe. Most importantly, they make parents feel better. Only one problem, however, some young people have been attacked by thieves who want to steal their mobile phones. Young people like going out with friends, but they now need to learn how to get home safely. 5 million young people in the UK between the ages of 9 to 16 use chat rooms to make friends, but they need to be careful and never give their personal details to a stranger. Young people today have more opportunities to meet new people and go out at night than their parents ever did. So, second reading. The long summer holidays are finally over and some parents are pleased. العطلة الصيفية الطويلة انتهت أخيراً وبعض الآباء فرحوا لذلك. But why? ولكن لماذا? We worry very much about their safety in the holidays. نخاف على كثيراً على سلامتهم في العطلة. Explains one mother from North London. فسرت لنا ذلك أم من شمال لندن. If teenagers are not wandering around on public transport in a big and dangerous city, they are chatting to strangers in an internet chat room. إذا لم يتجول المراهقون حول النقل العمومي في المدن الكبيرة والخطيرة، فإنهم يتحدثون مع غرباء في غرفة الدردشة على الإنترنت. Weekends are not the only time to worry. عطلة نهاية الأسبوع ليست الوقت الوحيد للقلق. Newspapers are full of stories about too many school kids going to school by car because their parents do not want them to travel alone on a bus or a train. الصحف مليئة بالقصص عن ذهاب عدد كبير جدا من أطفال المدارس إلى المدرسة بالسيارة لأن والديهم لا يريدونهم أن يسافروا بمفردهم في الحافلة أو القطار. This summer, there were more frightening stories of teenagers disappearing with unsuitable friends that they met on the net. هذا الصيف كان هناك المزيد من القصص المخيفة عن اختفاء مراهقين مع أصدقاء السوء. Unsuitable friends هم أصدقاء السوء التقوا بهم عبر الإنترنت. All the media stories help increase parents' fears. كل قصص وسائل الإعلام The media هم وسائل الأعلام تساعد في زيادة مخاوف الآباء. Parents' fears هي مخاوف الآباء. Many young people feel that life for their parents was easier. يشعر الكثير من الشباب أن حياة آبائهم كانت أسهل. In 1960s, young people played in the streets more and traveled around the town without their parents. ففي الستينات كان الشباب يلعبون في الشوارع أكثر ويتنقلون في أنحاء المدينة دون والديهم. Now many young people have mobile phones and their parents ring to find out where they are. اليوم يمتلك العديد من الشباب هواتف محمولة ليتصل بهم آباؤهم لمعرفة مكانهم. I use my mobile to get dad to come to the station when I arrive late. 16-year-old Jane said. قالت جين البالغة من العمر 16 عاماً أستخدم هاتفي الجوال لأتصل بأبي ليأتي يأخذني من المحطة عندما أصل متأخرة. Mobiles are not just expensive toys. الهواتف الجوالة أو المحمولة ليست مجرد ألعاب باهظة الثمن. They help keep young people safe. فهي تساعد على الحفاظ على سلامة الشباب. Most importantly, they make parents feel better. والأهم من ذلك، فهي تجعل الآباء يشعرون بالراحة أكثر. Only one problem, however, some young people have been attacked by thieves who want to steal their mobile phones. بينما هنالك مشكلة فقط هي أن بعض الشباب تعرضوا للهجوم من قبل اللصوص يريدون سرقة هواتفهم الجوالة أو المحمولة. Thieves هم اللصوص. To steal يعني يسرق. Young people like going out with friends but they now need to learn how to get home safely. يحب الشباب الخروج مع الأصدقاء ولكنهم اليوم بحاجة إلى تعلم كيفية العودة إلى المنزل بأمان. 5 million young people in the UK between the ages of 9 to 16 use chat rooms to make friends. 5 ملايين شاب في المملكة المتحدة in the UK. UK هي المملكة المتحدة البريطانية. تتراوح أعمارهم بين 9 و16 عاما يستخدمون غرف الدردشة لبناء صداقات. But they need to be careful and never give their personal details to a stranger. ولكن عليهم توخي الحذر. Be careful. توخي الحذر وعدم إعطاء بياناتهم الشخصية personal details هي البيانات الشخصية لأي شخص غريب. A stranger هو شخص غريب. Young people today have more opportunities to meet new people and go out at night than their parents ever did. يتمتع الشباب اليوم بفرص أكثر لمقابلة أشخاص جدد والخروج ليلا أكثر مما كان يفعل آباؤهم. Now let's answer comprehension questions. So question number one, the text deals with. The text deals with. We have three choices. So A, a new friendship. B, a frightening story. C, a newspaper article. So the text deals with a new friendship, صداقة جديدة. A frightening story, قصة مخيفة. أو a newspaper article. Article أو هو مقال من جريدة. So the correct answer is a newspaper article. Question number two. Correct these false statements with information from the text. سوف نقوم بإصلاح هذه الجمل بمعلومات من النص. Some parents are pleased when the summer holidays are over because they want their children to go back to school. الآباء فرحوا لانتهاء العطلة الصيفية لأنهم يريدون أبناءهم أن يعودوا إلى مقاعد الدراسة. طبعاً خطأ. The answer is in paragraph 1. So what she says, one mother from North London, we worry very much about their safety in the holidays. نخاف على سلامتهم في العطلة. So the correct answer, some parents are pleased when the summer holidays are over. Because they are worried about their children's safety in the holidays. يخافون على سلامة أبنائهم في العطلة. لماذا؟ لأنهم يتجولون في أنحاء المدينة ويلعبون في الشوارع. Question number two. A. So let's move to B now. Teenagers' favorite pastimes during the summer holidays are reading books and practicing sports. Teenagers' favorite pastimes during the summer holidays are reading books and practicing sports. الوقت أو وقت الفراغ المفضل بالنسبة للمراهقين يريدون قضاءه في قراءة الكتب أو لعب الرياضة. Of course, it's false. The correct answer is in paragraph 1-2. So if teenagers are not wandering around on public transport in a big and dangerous city, they are chatting to strangers in an internet chat room. إذن ما يفعله المراهقون خلال العطلة ليس قراءة الكتب ولعب الرياضة, but they wander around on public transport in a big and dangerous city, or they chat to strangers in an internet chat room. Sentence C. Chatmates are usually safe friends. Chatmates are usually safe friends. Of course, it's false. The correct answer is in paragraph 2. This summer, there were more frightening stories of teenagers disappearing with unsuitable friends that they met on the net. هذا الصيف كانت هناك قصص مخيفة حول اختفاء مراهقين مع أصحاب السوء تعرفوا عليهم عبر الإنترنت. So chatmates are not safe friends. This summer, there were more frightening stories of teenagers disappearing with unsuitable friends that they met on the net. Sentence D. Life in the past was less secure for teenagers than now. Life in the past was less secure for teenagers than now. الحياة في الماضي كانت أقل أمان بالنسبة للمراهقين من اليوم. Of course, it's false. The correct answer is in paragraph 3. In 1960s, young people played in the streets more. في الستينات كان الشباب يلعبون في الشارع أكثر. And traveled around the town without their parents. ويسافرون أو يتنقلون حول أنحاء المدينة دون آبائهم. وهذا دليل على أن الحياة في الماضي كانت أكثر more secure for teenagers than now. So the correct answer is in 1960s, young people played in the streets more and traveled around the town without their parents. The last sentence. Only a few teenagers make new friendships through the internet. Only a few teenagers make new friendships through the internet. فقط عدد قليل من المراهقين يقومون ببناء علاقات عبر الانترنت. The correct answer is in paragraph 4. 5 million young people in the UK between the ages of 9 to 16 use the chat rooms to make friends. So it's not a few teenagers. But many, 5 million young people, 5 ملايين young people in the UK between the ages of 9 to 16 use chat rooms to make friends. Let's move now to question number 3. Complete the statements below with information from the text. سوف نقوم بإكمال الجمل التالية بمعلومات من النص. So, sentence A, mobile phones help teenagers be safe because. الهواتف الجوالات تساعد المراهقين بأن يكونوا في أمان. لماذا؟ Because لأنهم يستطيعون الاتصال بوالديهم في أي وقت. مثل المثال بالنسبة لجين في النص, اتصلت بأبيها كي يأتي يأخذها عندما وصلت إلى المحطة متأخرة. So mobile phones help teenagers be safe because they can call their parents at any time. يتصلون بوالديهم في أي وقت. And ask them to meet them at the station if they arrived late. Sentence B. Mobile phones help parents feel better as regards their children because. الهواتف الجوالة تساعد الآباء على الشعور بالراحة أكثر تجاه أبنائهم. لماذا؟ لأنهم يستطيعون الاتصال بهم لمعرفة مكانهم. So because they can ring their children to find out where they are. Sentence C. The stories that parents read about in the newspapers make them feel. القصص التي يقرأها الآباء في الجرائد تجعلهم يشعرون بماذا؟ بالسعادة, بالحزن, بالفرح, بالخوف, بماذا؟ So the stories that parents read about in the newspapers make them feel more frightened about their children. يشعرون بالخوف أكثر على أبنائهم. The last sentence: When teenagers chat with people they don't know, they shouldn't. عندما يتحدث المراهقون مع أشخاص لا يعرفونهم، عليهم عدم ماذا؟ عدم إعطاء بياناتهم الشخصية. So when teenagers chat with people they don't know, they shouldn't give them their personal details like their identity or address. Identity هي الهوية، address هو العنوان. Question number 4. Why do many young people think that life for their parents was easier? لماذا يظن الكثير من الشباب بأن حياة آبائهم كانت أسهل؟ الإجابة في الفقرة الثالثة. In 1960s, young people played in the streets more and traveled around the town without their parents. طالما الشباب في الستينات يلعبون في الشوارع أكثر ويسافرون حول أنحاء المدينة دون والديهم، هو دليل على أن الحياة في الماضي كانت أكثر أمان وأقل عنف، إذن وأكثر أمان. So, many young people think that life for their parents was easier because there was less violence and more security. أقل عنف وأكثر أمان. The last question, so question number 5. What do the underlined words refer to? على ماذا تعود الكلمات التالية؟ They are in paragraph 3. So let's read the sentence from paragraph 3. Now many young people have mobile phones and their parents ring to find out where they are. اليوم الكثير من الشباب لديهم هواتف جوالة وأباؤهم يتصلون بهم، يتصلون بمن؟ ب young people. So they are, they refers to young people. Be now, they help in paragraph 3 also. So let's read the sentence from paragraph 3. Mobiles are not just expensive toys, they help keep young people safe. الهواتف الجوالة ليست فقط ألعاب باهظة الثمن، فهي تساعد من؟ من؟ They help هم. Mobiles also, so they refers to mobiles. Let's move now to language. Choose the correct option. سوف نقوم باختيار الإجابة الصحيحة. I just want you know, knowing now that we are in holidays. We are in a great place. The people are friendly. The food is excellent and the weather is. So here, paragraph starts with the simple present. I have the verb want in the simple present. And I have after it verb to know. So we have want in the simple present. The verb coming after want should be in the infinitive form. Whenever we have two verbs, the second verb should be in the infinitive form. So I just want you know that we are in holidays. So here I have to use the infinitive because the first verb is in the simple present. We are in a great place. The people are friendly. The food is excellent and the weather is much best, better, well. So we have then at home. When I have the word then, means that I have to use the comparative form. سأستعمل المقارنة. المقارنة عندما بخلاصة أو بعجالة القاعدة بالنسبة للcomparative عندما يكون لديكم adjective قصير متكون من one syllable من جزء واحد مثل hard, slim, big, etc. So I have to add er at the end of the adjective. And when I have a long adjective like expensive, important, comfortable, etc., I have to use more plus adjective plus than. So here I have best or better or well. Here the adjective is good. Is good. It's an irregular adjective. Irregular adjective. The comparative form of good is better. Better than. إذا لم تفهموا القاعدة بالنسبة للcomparative اكتبوا لي تعليق وأنا سأقوم بشرح درس الcomparative form. So it's cloudy, sunny or rainy. طالما هو قال لنا بأن the weather is much better. So it's sunny every day. مشمس sunny. Last Saturday I got on the bus and went or have gone or go to the north of the island. So we have last Saturday. Whenever you have the word last, automatically you have to use the simple past. الماضي البسيط. So last Saturday I got on, verb to get in the simple past is got, the bus and went. So the simple past of the verb go is went to the north of the island. It's very nice, but I must tell you about my experience in a self-service. I went into a restaurant and sat down, but nobody came to serve me. لم يأتي أحد لخدمتي. So nobody came to serve me. I saw there weren't any or some or no waiters. الويتر هو النادل الذي يقدم لك الطعام في المطعم. So there weren't any waiters. لم يكن هنالك أحد. The customers stood in a queue. A queue يعني صف واحد وراء واحد. And got their food by themselves. إذن يقومون بخدمة أنفسهم أو بأخذ الطعام بأنفسهم. So هنا علينا استعمال reflexive pronoun by themselves. يقومون بالفعل بأنفسهم. Every day I learn new things about the English culture. So let's read the whole paragraph. I just want you to know that we are in holidays. We are in a great place. The people are friendly. The food is excellent and the weather is much better than at home. It's sunny every day. Last Saturday, I got on the bus and went to the north of the island. It's very nice, but I must tell you about my experience in a self-service. I went into a restaurant and sat down, but nobody came to serve me. I saw there weren't any waiters. The customers stood in a queue and got their food by themselves. Every day, I learn new things about the English culture. Question number two. Write the words or the verbs between parentheses in the correct tense or form. سنقوم بتصريف الأفعال أو الكلمات التالية في التنس المناسب أو وضع الكلمة في الفورم المناسب. So good evening and welcome everybody. Tonight we are looking at the problem of football attend, which decreased by nearly 50% since 1950s. Even tonight we are looking. Tonight we are looking. So the verb is are looking at the problem of football attend. So هنا الحضور الكروي. We need a noun. So the verb is attend and the noun is attendance. الحضور الكروي. Which decreased by nearly 50% since 1950s. Whenever you have the word since, you have to use the present perfect tense. The rule of the present perfect is has or have plus past participle. So here, which has decreased by nearly 50% since 1950s. Many clubs are in finance trouble. Trouble means problem. And tonight we would like to identify the main causes and discuss some possible solutions. So many clubs are in مشاكل مادية. Finance means money. So هنا finance نعني بها المشاكل المادية. Financial trouble. We say financial trouble. Our guest هو الضيف, is Jimmy, the ex-Scotland strike who just returned from the US. After spending 2 years with Miami Galaxy. So our guest is Jimmy, the ex-Scotland. The verb is strike who. So here we are talking about a person. Whenever we are talking about a person, we add er to the verb or just are like the example here, strike. So we add er only to have the noun striker. Like teach, teacher, we add er. Play, player, we add er. To form the noun. So here we have the verb ends with E. So we add just R. Who just returned from the US after spending 2 years with Miami Galaxy. So here we have the word just. Whenever you have the word just also, you have to use the present perfect tense. So who has just returned from the US. Well, Jimmy, what should we do about the problem? I have been playing in the United States for the last two seasons. So here we have for, the word for, من التي تعني ابتداء الأكشن في الماضي ولا زالت متواصلة. So here we have to use the present perfect progressive. So I have been playing. I have been playing. The rule is have plus been plus verb plus ing in the United States for the last. So I have been playing in the United States for the last two seasons. And I not see any violence over there. من تلك اللحظة إلى يومنا هذا لم أرى أي عنف هناك. So I have to use the present perfect. I haven't seen or I have not seen any violence over there. A football match is a day out for the family. More than half the support, the verb is support, are women and children. And here we have the word the after the verb. So here we need a noun because we are talking about women and the children. And the verb is support. We have to use ers because we are talking about women and the children. So the supporters are women and the children. And there are many facilities. Everybody gets a comfortable seat. There are good restaurants and there is entertain. وسائل ترفيه أو ترفيه before and after the match and at half time. So there is entertainment, ترفيه before and after the match and at half time. Over here, football stadiums are old, cold and dirty. I think we have got a lot to learn. The last question, so we have unscrambled the words to make meaningful sentences. سوف نقوم بترتيب الكلمات. لدينا كلمات غير مرتبة. سوف نقوم بترتيبها للحصول على جملة مفيدة. So sentence number one, we have do you what on nights do Friday and a question mark. إذن 5 ثواني للتفكير. So the correct answer is, what do you do on Friday nights? What do you do on Friday nights? Sentence number two. We have busy I weeks in last the was too very. Busy تعني مشغول. إذن 5 ثواني للتفكير في الإجابة الصحيحة. So the correct answer is, I was very busy in the last 2 weeks. I was very busy in the last 2 weeks. Sentence number three. Pupils who the hard will work succeed. So 5 ثواني للتفكير في الإجابة الصحيحة. The correct answer is, the pupils who work hard will succeed. The pupils who work hard will succeed. Sentence number four. I, depressed, get comfort, turn food to whenever I fall. 5 seconds to think about it. 5 ثواني للتفكير. So the correct answer is, whenever I get depressed, I turn to food for comfort. Whenever I get depressed, I turn to food for comfort. The last sentence, we have family. Does your dinner have went together? A question mark. 5 ثواني للتفكير. So the correct answer is, when does your family have dinner together? When does your family have dinner together? So thank you for your attention and good luck in your first English final exam. Goodbye, see you soon and goodbye.